All right, Drake just dropped a diss track against the entire industry. I'm in a hotel room right now. I'm not at home, but we gotta react to this. All right. Apparently, he goes against absolutely everyone. People say it might be AI. It leaked. I don't know. Let's hear it. Okay. Four minutes long, bro. You talk about J. Cole? Can't get booked outside America for now. I'm out in Tokyo because I'm big in Japan. I'm the hit maker, y'all depend on. Not true, bro. Like, that just went number one. And he's probably going to say that's because of the diss. Bro, not true. Maybe he's talking about Future. Maybe. But, like, come on, dude. Like, yeah, you make hits, but we don't need you. Come on. Come on. It was friend zone. You won't never take no chain off of us. How the fuck you been stepping with a size 7 men's on? How you big stepping with a size 7? Bro. Okay. Dude, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. Kendrick might be short, bro. He bodies Drake. Come on, dude. That's a low blow. I know my picture on the wall when y'all cook up. Extortion, baby. Whole career, you been shook up. Cause top, so you drop and give me 50 like some push ups. Your last one brick. You really not on shit. Last one bricked? Dude, come on. They make excuses for you because they hate to see me lit. Pull your contract because we got to see the split. Hey, the way you doing splits, bitch, your pants might rip. You better do that motherfucking show inside the bitty. Maroon 5 need a verse, you better make it witty. Maroon 5. Need a verse for the Swifties. Swifties? Better drop and give them 50. Pip squeak. She's saying he's like a feature merchant? That's, bro, if anyone's a feature merchant, it's Drake. Dude, don't bring them into this. Bro, Trav is not taking your side, bro. No, he's not. Boy, you in a scope right now. And you gon' feel the aftermath of what I write down. I'm at the top of the mountain, so you tight now. Just to have this talk with your ass, I had to hike down. Big difference between Mike and Mike now. What the fuck is this, a 20v1? 20v1. Bro, that show, dude, he's gotta make friends, bro. You are not gonna have any features on the next album. He's not getting another Metro beat. Bro, shut your ass up and make some drums. Like, come on. You can't reduce him to that. That's like saying to Drake, like, shut the fuck up and speak some words. Like, bro, Metro is like the fucking producer of our times. It, like, you can't just reduce him that. Wicked. What? Dude, Drake's never done Rolling Loud. They do not. Yeah, he does not. Fuck, he's like the only big artist that's like never done a Rolling Loud. Dude, I don't see, this is why people are upset at Drake in the first place, because he's been doing this shit for like 10 years. He's been pushing people aside, pushing aside Rolling Loud, and then shit with like J. Cole and Kendrick. He does all these subliminals. It adds up to this. There's a reason why this is a 20v1, and he's got to acknowledge that. You can't say like, oh yeah, you can go do your thing. I'm good by myself. Because, like, that's how you've been losing so many people's trust over the years. It's been building up. So, like, you do something like this, you're just going to lose more, bro. Like, he's digging himself a hole. Rick Ross? 50. I mean, dude, wait. Bust out the gritty. Drake is, like, pushing damn. Like, ain't he, like, 37 or 38, bro? Like, he cannot be talking about age out here. I mean, I get, like, a lot of artists are aging now, but, I mean, yeah, Future's in his 40s, I think, like, damn near. I think he just turned 40. So, like, but, Drake, you're not that far behind. Like, come on. And was that about Pusha 40? Like, okay, I mean, bro, if you want to bring Pusha into this, oh, my God. Can you imagine if we get Kendrick and Pusha on one shit? Oh, my God, that is bad. I know why you mad, nigga. I ain't even tripping. First off, I want to say this right now. So far, not compared. Even Duffy Freestyle is better than this shit, bro. Like, he's just digging a hole. Come on. After this, I'm way too big. Top Dogs. Yeah. Dude, yeah, I mean, like, even Duppy Freestyle is better than this, and I got bodied by Story of Addie Dawn. So, like, I don't see what he's really doing here. I think this is just, like, the whole thing he's talking about 20v1, and he's just saying, like, I don't need you, I don't need you, I don't need you, I don't need you. It's like, okay, can you, like, oh, and you're short, and you're old. It, like, dude, these are weak bars. Come on. And that fucking song y'all got is not starting beef with us. This shit been brewing in a pot, now I'm heating up. You're the one fucking starting it, bro. That song ain't starting beef with us. Like, you're falling for the bait right now, bro. Like, I don't care what Cole think, that dot shit was weak as fuck. Bro, that, like, see what I'm saying? Like now what's J. Cole gonna do? I mean, he was already on the Future album. So, like, they just finished the tour together, too. Like, he's just digging a hole, bro. Ain't tripping, he is not fucking easing up. Nigga caught a tie to see a top, wanna piece it up. Top, wanna piece it up. Top, wanna piece it up. Nah, pussy, now you on your own when you speaking up. You done roll deep to this, it's not fucking deep enough. And also, like, he's saying, like, that shit was weak. Dude, the Kendrick verse was not supposed to be, like, a complete diss track. He was just saying, separate me from you, I'm better. That was it. It was a verse. It was not a diss track. Right, because, like, Future didn't really say all that much on it about, like, dissing. I mean, on the album as a whole, he did, like, with, like, We Don't Trust You, and, I mean, a lot of the other things on it, too, obviously, even the name itself. But, like, come on, like, you can't be comparing that, like, oh, I have a better diss track now. Like, dude, be fucking for real. Begging Kaisa not? Dude, what wasn't Drake the one that wanted the, I mean, isn't he cool with Kai? See, bro, what is he doing? He literally has been photographed with Kai before. Why are you saying people begging to be with Kai to, like, beep up their numbers or whatever? When you're being photographed with Kai too. Like, you're not. This is weird. This is not how you, like. This ain't a beef. This is just like losing friends. This ain't even everything I know. He's heating up. Okay, so now he's asking for Kendrick to make a diss track? Like, so this is also bait. People are reaching out, so maybe people are picking sides. But here's the thing, dude. Look at 21 Savage. Look at Travis. They're like the two closest collaborators with, like, I'd say. See, here's the thing. 21 just did a lot of shit with Metro, right, on his newest album, and Travis is like, I mean, he was literally like the protege to Kanye. So he is not picking Drake's side, right? And that's the weird thing throughout this whole thing. Like, Drake's been at the concert, and he has the fucking Travis face that, when it plays Sicko Mode, like, shoots the fireworks and everything, right? And so they're cool, obviously. And Travis has always been this in-between. But you're not going to get Travis to pick a side, bro. You're not. I mean, Kanye isn't even either. But Kanye's not trying to drag him into this. And now you're name-dropping him, saying, like, they're going to pick a side. You're reaching out. And they're picking my side. So you better be careful. Like, dude. They're not gonna fucking ruin their career. They're not gonna do what you're doing by, like, ruining their other friendships just for this beef, bro. Song for 4 years to drop that shit. Is that Red Leather? I think that might be because Red Leather was a leak, and then J. Cole added the verse onto it. So yeah, he's distancing himself from J. Cole too. It's me twice in my big three. I had to leave you out. Me twice in the big three. And that's it. Me twice in the big three? I mean, dude, the whole big three thing is fucking stupid to begin with. When, I mean, I love Kendrick and Cole, but they barely drop anymore. Like Drake, fine, because you're dropping a shit ton of quantity that, I mean, I don't know if it's really, like, good albums, but, you know, it's quantity and you get bangers on each album. But, like, dude, I mean, the big three right now, it like, if we're talking about new gen, if we're talking about, like, this second, if we're talking the 2010s, if we're talking all rap, like, who's relevant right now? I don't know if Drake's, like, actually like influencing and doing a ton of shit like he used to, right? Like Trav is definitely in that big three. And look at Cardi, bro. Cardi's got to be in that big three. So I don't know. I mean, and then who gets the other slot, bro? Like Future's been doing a lot of shit recently. I mean, it's hard to say that there's two. The big three is two of you. Then who would it be the other one? Trav? But like, come on. I mean, like, there's way more. Like I said, Cardi is like on top of the world right now with fucking all his feature run, the singles he's been dropping. So like, you gotta like reevaluate what you're saying here. I mean, yeah, I don't think the big three right now is Cole, Kendrick, or Drake anyway. Like, Cole, dude, like that guy has not been dropping shit consistently for, 6 years. So what? Why be in that conversation, right? Like, who's running the game right now, consistently influencing new people, bringing people up, and starting new trends in music? It's not them, right? Okay, well, I think this is definitely more bait. I think it's just him distancing. So what comes out of this? I think like an actual diss track, right? I think that this just starts the ignition for the actual diss tracks, because this is just him distancing himself from everyone. But it's not a smart move, bro, because you're not gonna win. What all Drake has going, and he says this in the song too, is, "Oh, I could get your girl. Oh, I'm gonna sleep with your girl that you're going with." Ha ha. Like, okay. What about like actual? What about the actual music, bro? Because that's what they're gonna critique you on. And like your track history and all that shit. So I think this is stupid on Drake's end to be doing this. I think that this was purposefully leaked. This is real. I want to say this is definitely real. Okay. Definitely real. But I think that this was purposefully leaked and not put out by him. So that way, if the reception is bad, he can say, "Oh, no. I was just AI. It was just AI, guys. Chill out." Because I've seen people already say it's AI. This is not AI. The AI is not there. These bars would only come from Drake. Like, these are typical Drake bars. So there's no way that this is not AI. It's not AI. But yeah, I think it's definitely a Drake move to leak it like this so he can have that safeguard, because Drake doesn't like being fucking, he doesn't go 100%. You know what I mean? He likes to play it safe. And I think that's exactly what he's doing right here. So, dude, this was weak as fuck, in my opinion. I think even Duppy Freestyle was better, even though it was like not that insane. I mean, Story added on bodied it, right? But like at least that song had some, like, "I would never have a Virgil in my circle and hold him back, and the father had to stretch his hands to take it from me." Like, those that were actually like somewhat clever. This is just like, okay, oh, go write a song for the Swifties. Like, what are we doing? Like 5'7" shoe, like, or sorry, the size 7 shoe. It's like, what are we doing? What are we doing? So I think this is weak. I hope that this ignites something out of this. I think that Kendrick might have something locked and loaded, but who's on it, right? Does he bring in, does Metro also hop on it again? Does Future hop on it again? Like you said, it's a 20v1. So is everyone gonna drop their own diss track? I don't know. I think it's probably just Kendrick. But he set himself up for failure here. So I don't know. We'll see what happens from that. But hey, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to like, comment, subscribe. We'll be keeping track of this beef in the future and everything that comes out of it. All right, I'll see you next one. Peace.